Patriots now getting ready to kick it away. Start this return, and they tag him down at the 37-yard line. What a good job of the kickoff team. The ball's kicked high in the air, and they sprint all the way down there. The blockers can't get set up. Nice tackle. Now they got great field position for the defense. First and 10. Trying to work that left side. I think the best thing to say about that play is just that it gained a few yards, so that's what you do. All plays don't score. Sometimes you just want to pick up a couple yards. Now they'll try over again on second down. Trying to get it outside before the defense is set. Going to lose yards here. That last play was a run. Third down coming up. Working that left side. The flag is out as the play continues. That's a face mask call, and of course, from now on, it's 15 yards no matter how you slice it. They don't even have to interpret it anymore. The severity of it, it's a big penalty.
Yeah, it is a big penalty. You know, one thing, you know why we see a lot of face mask penalties in the NFL now? It's because players tackle too high. Get your arms around the waist. Go down low to make those tackles, and you wouldn't get those face mask penalties.
Second down. Gets it again here. That's a gain of 7.
Well, what you try to do so many times in the NFL, do the unexpected. The defense is expecting pass all the way. Everybody's running to the quarterback. What do? You confuse them. You mix them up. You run the draw play. That's why it was an easy run.
He'll throw it over the middle. He's brought down at the 23-yard line.
Nice job by the receiver catching the football there and takes the hit down below the waist. And nowadays, with the rules of the NFL, you got to learn to know defensive players are going to start hitting you lower.
First down at 10. Looking across the middle.
That incompletion by the quarterback. Hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
The offense heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position, nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
This will be the 8th play of this drive. 3rd and 10. Challenging the defenders to the right side. That pass, well defended. The Vikings getting set for the field goal. The kick is good.
Well, when you get points, it's never a bad thing. That is for sure. Good job by the field goal kicker that time. Nice job by the offense moving the football down the field.
We'll take it at this point. Patriots come on the field now for this next series. Split backfield here. 1st and 10. They feed the running back. Nice tackle.
You got to keep your offensive line aggressive. So you got to let them run the football so they can hit those defensive linemen. The run didn't pick up many yards, but it's still serving.
They bring in an extra defensive back. 2nd and 9. Back to the running back. Brought to the ground.
An off-tackle run, it's a staple of all offenses in the NFL. And a general rule is you run off the right tackle because he is the power tackle, where the left tackle is the pass blocker.
Staying on the ground. Breaks free, has some space to work with. Holding. That penalty is, of course, going to be accepted by the defense. Long odds facing the offense after that penalty on 3rd down and 12.
Good solid tackle. Short of the first. Now we've got a 4th down situation.
down on fourth down for getting the punt.
They have been penalized now on offense six times today.
Defense.
Grabbing the base pass. We see it almost once a week, and here it happens again.
Well, a lot of times these defenders, I'll give them a little slack because they're running so fast and trying to tackle some tremendous athletes in open space, and sometimes accidentally you're going to grab the face mask. When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Here, a split backfield, second and six. Go running with him again.
Good job of the defensive line standing there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
Play number six coming up on this drive. Third and three. Another handoff. Gains 20.
You see a long run like that, you know what it does? It just breaks the will of the defense. In the NFL, it's all about passing. You see all these wonderful things. But when it comes down to it, who can win the war up front? And you win the war by running the football. Great job on the offensive line that time.
Really important they find a way to score in this drive here. So close to the goal line, they got to get back in this game. And if they find a way to score, even though they'll still be behind, it'll give them a lot of confidence. This will be the eighth play of this drive. Back to the ground. Over the line. Touchdown. The Patriots for the extra point. It's good. The Vikings are ready to return the kickoff. He'll have a chance to take off. That is also seven penalties now on the offense today. Defense will not decline to take the penalty. The Vikings are getting set for their next possession. First down here. Hand off to the back. They've got him down there.
Well, a short gain on the run that time by the offense. When you're a running football team, listen, there's going to be a lot of ugly plays that don't work. You just got to keep running it.
The defense comes out of the nickel. Second down and seven. Will run with it again. The tackle is going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker.
It's a mindset. It's a culture. That's what you got to create when you talk about running the football. And when you get it going the right way, you can grind the defense up. Another first down for this offense running the football.
15 minutes to go. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. First down coming up. Staying with the running game on first down.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home, they stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
And here we have second down. The quarterback throws to the right. Takes out the defender right there on the spot. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game.
And he gains maybe three.
This quarterback runs so well, he just expects that they're going to have a spy on him. Well, that's good. You might stop him from running now, but the problem is, he can still throw it down the field on him.
They send the tight end in motion. Second down at seven. They hand it off to the running back.
Good job that time by the offense. Now a run gets him a few yards.
Some good news on the injury. It does not appear to be as serious as we first thought, and he is expected to get back into this game.
Yeah, he's going to come back in. I mean, that's good news for him. I don't know if the team's too happy about it because he's playing awful. But, you know, if he gets back out there, maybe he can change things around.
Looking for an open receiver on the right. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
You know, as a quarterback, sometimes you got to trust that arm and throw the football past the first down marker. There were guys open, but no, he takes the safe route, throws it short, defense makes the tackle, and here we are staring at a fourth down.
That's a touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20. They face first down. The quarterback will hand it off. Gains 13.
You see a long run like that, you know what it does? It just breaks the will of the defense. In the NFL, that's all about passing. You see all these wonderful things. But when it comes down to it, who can win the war up front? And you win the war by running the football. Great job on the offensive line that time.
We're late in the fourth, and the offense is just trying to sit on the lead. Another carry here. For the eighth time, they are flagged. Boy, this head got yanked back the other way. An obvious face mask penalty, and that's a big one.
It's about safety of the players, too. That's why when you grab, hit the helmet in certain situations, it's going to be a 15-yard penalty. Don't grab the face mask.
He's brought to a halt.
Personal foul. Defense.
That's a face mask call, and of course from now on it's 15 yards no matter how you slice it. They don't even have to interpret it anymore. The severity of it, it's a big penalty.
Yeah, it is a big penalty. You know, one thing, you know why we see a lot of face mask penalties in the NFL now? It's because players tackle too high. Get your arms around the waist. Go down low to make those tackles, and you wouldn't get those face mask penalties.
We're late in the fourth, and it's time now to call on that ballyhooed defense. Time for them to make a stop. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
Good job by the offense getting another first down. You can tell by looking down on the field that defense, hands on their knees, they are getting tired.
He gets it again on this drive. And you can see how they fared in the red zone to this point, which is brought to you by Verizon. Verizon, rule the air. Two minutes remaining, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. Feed him the ball again. Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
I think you can just tell by the body language, the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out.
Back to the ground now on first down. And we'll try to conserve time here with this timeout. About to snap it for the ninth play of the drive. And he's in for the touchdown. Extra point attempt now. The point after try is in the books. Steven Gostkowski is readying his team for the kickoff. He's got a chance to return this one. Bites off the hip.
Holding by the receiving team.
Defense will take the penalty. Vikings come onto the field for their next series.
It's a dime look for the defense on this play. Now first and 10. Safety valve time. And that's a gain of 10.
Jim, that was some job of making the catch and holding on to the football. You can hear that hit all the way up here in the booth.
Second down now. Takes the snap from the shotgun. Looking to the right side and throwing. Throws a strike.
Good job by the receiver running into that defense, through the zone, finding the open space and making a nice catch.
There's the flag on the play. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Defense was trying to guess the snap count, and it cost him there. Able to move the chains after that penalty. Drop back, shotgun formation. Trying to work the middle of the field. The tackle was made.
This offense, they are methodical, aren't they? And kind of boring to watch. First down, first down, first down.
Snap back to the quarterback, out of the gun. No one in sight, has the grab. Hold on a minute, there's an injured player on the field.
Well, that's a good sight for all the fans to see. He gets up and walks off the field, and I think he's going to be okay. He's just going to need a couple minutes to catch his breath and see him back on the field. Looks like short.
They're going to the hurry-up offense, and they're back to the line quickly. You talk about dreaming big. You got to score here, and then you need all kinds of breaks to still pull this one. Play number six coming up on this drive. It's a throw all the way. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
Well, that looks like an upper body injury, Jim. I think you both can tell that. And now the question is, how bad is it? You just never know.
First and 10, going off tackle here. There's the flag on the field. Grabbing the face mask. We see it almost once a week, and here it happens again.
Well, a lot of times these defenders, I'll give them a, you know, a little slack because they're running so fast, they're trying to tackle some tremendous athletes in open space, and sometimes accidentally, you're going to grab the face mask.
Gets past the first wave, and he's brought down right at the 42. They come to the line of scrimmage, first down. They hand it off to him again. That's a gain of six. That'll stop the clock with that timeout. Offense lines up here. Second down and four. Right back to him one more time. The defense accepts the penalty. After that penalty, it's now second and 14. Staying on the ground. Breaks free, and he is tackled at the 44. After that run, third and 8 for the offense. Out of the shotgun formation. And he's taken down. The New England Patriots have won the Super Bowl. And the Lombardi Trophy is going back to Foxborough. You were the first to ever say, after a Super Bowl victory, I'm going to Disneyland. Now, what about these players on the field here today?
I know you'll find this amazing. I did it without cue cards. I memorized that, and it was awesome. It was a great feeling.
holding the Lombardi Trophy triumphantly. What a season it's been for them, and no better way to top it off than with a Super Bowl victory. Truly a special moment. For Bill Simms and all the crew, I'm Jim Nantz. Stay tuned for the postgame wrap-up show, and we'll see you next year here on EA Sports.